The experimenter is Wien bridge oscillator. It is your sixth experiment, and for this also you are using IC741. As the name suggests, seventh pin and fourth pin is the supply. That is VCC plus VCC and minus VCC. Your sixth pin is the output, and your second pin is your 10K. That is R1 and R2, 10K and 22K. And here, unlike your pass filters, you have a pot which has to be adjusted. It's an adjustable pot, and you can adjust this pot, and you can get an oscillation in your V0. That is, you could vary the magnitude of your V0. And this is third pin. Third pin is connected with a feedback circuit, wherein a resistor is in series with the capacitor, and then a resistor in parallel with the capacitor is connected into this station. So these values, everything you have to calculate. So calculation part, you can see it here. See, the formula is A, that is gain equal to 1 by beta, which is greater than or equal to 3. Let us have it as equal to 3. So 1 plus R of divided by R1, that is feedback resistance divided by R1, that is R of divided by R1 is equal to 3. So R of is equal to 2 R1. So here R of by R1 is equal to 2. So you get R1 is 10 kilo ohms. So here they have asked you to find design a Wien bridge oscillator of frequency 100 Hz. So frequency is 100 Hz, and then R1 is 10 kilo ohms, and R of is 20 kilo Hz. So 20 kilo Hz, we doesn't have it in the laboratory. We have a 22K in the standard. It's a standard resistor. So 1 kilo ohms part is standard in series. So 1 kilo Hz. This 1 kilo Hz part. This 1 kilo Hz part. Kilo ohms part. 1 kilo ohms. This part is connected, and R1 is 10 kilo ohms, and R2 is 22 kilo ohms. Is connected as shown in the circuit diagram. So let us see what is F0. So F0 is given. Frequency is given as 100 ohms. Is 100 ohms or 500 ohms? Okay, let us say it is 500 ohms. So we know that F0 equal to 1 divided by 2 by RC. It has been already said in the pass filters. So assuming C 0.1 microfarad, we get R equal to 1 divided by 2 by F0 C. So you are rewriting this equation in this way, and you are getting R. So R is 3.183. You can see 3.183, 3.3, 3.183 we doesn't have. So we have 3.3 kilo ohms as the standard resistance that we have connecting here. 3.3 kilo ohms and 3.3 kilo ohms in the series and parallel fashion. And then, and this C is already, we have assumed 0.1 microfarad. So 0.1 microfarad and 0.1 microfarad is connected in series. And this particular thing is called feedback circuit in the Wien bridge oscillator. So this particular oscillator, when you vary the potentiometer, the signal gets oscillated. That's what Wien bridge oscillator is. So what is the procedure? How you have to do it in the lab is, step one is the circuit are connected as per the diagram. As per this diagram, as per the pin numbers, you have to connect. This is 3. As per the pin diagrams, you can connect in the hardware, that is in your springboard. The components can be get from the number lab assistant, and you could connect it as per the figure. And then step 2, power on the supply, and output waveform is observed in the CRO. So this output waveform is observed in the CRO. And then step 3, practical output frequency and amplitude are noted. So this output frequency and amplitude are noted in the scope, and then compare with the theoretical value. Theoretical value which you calculate, you compare it, and you will get a signal like this. So in this signal, this is the output signal. If you vary the potentiometer, that is 1 kilo ohms, that is 1 kilo ohms reduced or increased, this particular magnitude will be either increase or decrease. So the time period is equal to t equal to 1 by f. From this you can find the frequency and amplitude, you can measure and note it down. That's it, the Wien bridge oscillator. And let us see the hardware implementation of this particular experiment. Thank you. Okay, let us see the hardware realization of Wien bridge oscillator. So it's, as name suggests, it's an oscillator. So the circuits have been given in the springboard, and you can see the IC741 is clamped here, and then you can see the feedback capacitor and resistor. You can see the feedback capacitor and resistor which is connected in parallel and in series. You can see the resistor and capacitor connected in series, and resistor and capacitor connected in parallel. This is the feedback circuit. So this feedback circuit is connected to the IC741 in the third pin. So likewise, whatever the connection is given in the board, it isn't connected here. And you have a power supply, plus VCC and minus VCC from here, 13.6 and 13.7 voltage. And the corresponding output, you can see the output probe is taken here, and it is visible here in the scope. So you can see, and one thing I missed here is the potentiometer, which is in series with the R2.
So it is in series with the R2. This, if you vary, increase or decrease, you can see the variation in this brings the variation in your output. Can you see? I can vary the output of the, I could oscillate the output signal by varying the potentiometer. So this is how you design Weinberg oscilloscope. That's it. Thank you. So you are calculating the time period and frequency, and you are noting down. So this is Weinberg oscillator.